On the next Porn Law News from the PNTlive Network. The content that D&E Media produces is no more than an excuse to depict some of the most horrific abuse you would ever see of women. And specifically, some of the most horrific and degrading abuse you would ever see when it comes to women of color. D&E Media has quite a few websites. They have Ghetto Gaggers, Facial Abuse, Latina Abuse, Radical Jizlam, Black Payback, and I think some others that just aren't in my mind right now. But these particular websites, from my perspective, they have no artistic merit, none. From what I've heard, allegedly, some of the quote-unquote depiction of abuse, which they showcase in their online content, is in actuality real abuse. There have been allegations of the operators of D&E Media threatening the women who they film if they ever come forward, or if they were to ever come forward, in regards to what they endured. Over the past few months, since another independent investigative blogger and podcaster and veteran adult actress known as Melissa Hill has brought to light some of her concerns in regards to D&E Media, I've really been researching and looking more into the company myself. Now, since I have done so, I have noticed that the threats that have been ongoing, really, since I left the adult entertainment industry, and I never even worked for D&E Media, okay? I've just spoken out and people didn't like it. But since I have tackled the issue of D&E Media, I have noticed that the threats against me and my family have increased. And I have noticed that some of the videos that I've posted in regards to some of the issues surrounding D&E Media have been flagged, even though they have not been removed from social media. So as we move forward with this situation, it's going to be interesting. But what I wanted to really discuss tonight in regards to D&E Media is the fact that, at least starting around the year of 2010, from what I have been able to find, the company officially established itself in 2006. But since the year of 2010, an office of the United States government has essentially labeled the content of D&E Media as being obscene and as being vulgar and as being offensive. So the question is this particular legal situation that I'm going to share with many of you tonight something that could be utilized as the foundation to create a solid obscenity case against D&E Media, which could theoretically not only label what they create as abusography, but also label what they create as obscenity, which would in turn force the operators of D&E Media to face certain legalities, fines, and or do some prison time.